I've been working on a 2D roguelike platformer.
And I'm putting your suggestions in the game. And you'll never guess what one of these suggestions was.
Thank you so much for all the support on the last video. I loved reading every single one of your comments.
I know we didn't have much to start off with, but you guys had some ideas that we could implement straight away. Starting with this one.
By Oliver Beeb, who recommended keeping the camera static when jumping.
I completely agree.
So I downloaded the Cinemachine add-on, and here's the side-by-side comparison so you can see what a difference it makes. I also switched from an orthographic to a perspective camera. The parallax effect was having some issues with it jittering and lagging, and this seems to fix all my problems, so yay! All I really had to do was just offset the layers on the Z-axis.
And this took literally minutes. And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button.
Now we have to tackle combat.
Adding the abilities has to be some of the most fun I have had this week.
For now, I've just implemented a slam, slash, and a basic attack. The latter will be your bread and butter for hacking through enemies at the start of the game, but you will be able to unlock ways to make this more powerful, or even replace it completely as the game progresses. I also ended up overhauling my movement system a little bit.
As well, this is still a learning experience for me.
And I ultimately didn't like the feel of the character movement.
I decided to swap from a translation-based movement system to a velocity-based one.
And in my opinion, it makes such a difference.
Now, I'm no coder.
So if you do know any ways I can make this any better, please do advise down below. While making those adjustments, I did run into some
issues.
So after a bit of Googling, I realized I needed something called a ground jagger, which is essentially just a small box collider under the player, which would detect when you're standing on the tile map.
And I must say, this one implementation made such a difference in how I was able to operate with my animations and all sorts.
If, for example, I was able to update the slam ability so that if you decided to use it when in the air, you would throw yourself at the ground and it didn't break the animation completely. And are you really a game dev if you don't mess around with the settings to make things absolutely ridiculous like this?
You know what? Screw it. This goes in the game! The last thing I set up this week was a basic script for implementing the player health and progress system.
And for a rough draft, it does exactly what I needed to do. Now, it's nothing fancy at the moment, and it's not actually hooked up to any actual systems.
This is very foundational stuff that I can reuse for enemies, bosses, and all sorts later on. Speaking of enemies, that is exactly what I'm going to be adding this week.
I do have a ghoul, spitter, and summoner thus far, and I will be making a shadow wolf.
So just like SYB4, if you've got any suggestions for some enemy types you want to be in this game, let me know in the comments below. I do just have to show you this comment left by Diotex.
Thank you so much. You have no idea how much it meant reading this.
But if you are still here, why not go check out this video? Till next time, I'll see you later, and have a great day, guys. Bye.